Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. It's the morning. I'm going to be doing my morning routine. I'm trying to not put any product in my hair because I'm getting a bit of a flaky scalp. But welcome back to another ugly beauty news. These are short, bite-sized beauty cosmetic-related industry news that I didn't think were worthy of a whole When Beauty Turns Ugly video. So as always, I'm going to be doing my skincare routine. But first, I have a sponsor today. That is Dermatica and their new skincare line, which includes their Caring Squalane Cream Cleanser, Hydrating Hyaluronic Acid and Vitamin B5 Serum, Soothing Centella Moisturizer, Nourishing Ceramide Peptide Moisturizer, Balancing Glycerin Gel Cleanser, and a Restoring Ceramide Skin Balm. And Dermatica's new skincare routine, which I've probably been trying for about 2 months now, if not more, has been that perfect kind of fallback routine that when I know my skin's freaking out, I can rely on these products to kind of put my skin back to a good, healthy position. I've already cleansed using the Balancing Glycerin Gel Cleanser. This is an amazing, very gentle, non-stripping cleanser that's very good at removing sunscreen and makeup, as well as just being a nice cleanser, so a good double cleanse. As the name suggests, there is glycerin in here and you can feel that. It's like a thick serum texture that leaves your skin just feeling nicely untouched. But, hang on, but my favourite, and which is nearly empty and will be in my next empties video, is the Hydrating Hyaluronic Acid plus Vitamin B5 Serum. So before I use this, I'm just going to rehydrate my face. Ooh. And then just apply to my skin. I do like applying any kind of hyaluronic acid serum over a hydrated face, not because it works any better or worse, either way, but just because I like the dewier looking appearance that it gives my skin. And this serum is great for all skin types, whether you're oily, combination, more on the drier side. Of course, hyaluronic acid is great for hydrating the skin. We have niacinamide to help even out skin tone. I also say refine the skin because we know niacinamide does a whole plethora of things. But one of my favorite benefits of niacinamide, as I've mentioned before, is it helps regulate sebum production. Niacinamide has been a game-changing ingredient for me and my skin for about 10 years now. Pantenol to help soothe, Centella Asiatica helps soothe and heal. It's a really nice all-rounder that leaves your skin just looking and feeling plump and hydrated. And let's revisit a product that I mentioned before and is one of my favorites. That's their Clarifying Azelaic Acid 20% Cream. I mentioned in my How I Treat Rosacea video that azelaic acid has been something that I use regularly now to kind of help maintain any kind of flushes, redness, the tiny little spots that you get along with rosacea, but also helps even out texture and tone of the skin. And what I love about Dermatica's in particular compared to other brands' azelaic acids, just use a little bit here. Yeah, on my nose, is that it's combined with squalane and glycerin. So unlike a lot of other azelaic acid serums or creams, it's not drying. It doesn't feel like powdery and gritty some azelaic acid creams feel. It actually has this nice moisturizing kind of effect and feel on the skin. Azelaic acid is one of those ingredients that when people discover it, they kind of don't stop talking about it. So it's like constantly going viral, but I do feel like it deserves to get the attention it gets. Of course, the link for Dermatica's new skincare routine products will be in the description box down below. And you can use code JAMESW to get 25% off the whole range and the azelaic acid cream. And thank you again to Dermatica for sponsoring this segment of today's video. So let's get into today's first story. And I actually really love this. Superdrug, which is like, how do you explain it? I don't know what the equivalent is in America. Like Sephora, but cheaper and more accessible. They have discounted their own brand sunscreen, Solait, calling sunscreen a health care essential, cutting the price by 20%. And that makes their most expensive sunscreen only $6.99 for 400 milliliters, which is an absolute bargain, like an absolute bargain. This comes after a number of cancer charities here in the UK have been campaigning to make sunscreens VAT exempt. And this is after a statement from Melanoma Focus here in the UK found that 1 in 10 people across the UK do not wear sunscreen because it's too expensive. Jamie Archer, who is Superdrug's own brand director, they have a few own brands, I think like B is one of them, commented saying that sunscreen is currently classed as a cosmetic product and therefore carries the VAT associated with it, making it unaffordable for some people. Through our work with beauty banks, we know that requests for donations of sun care products have gone up, with some people even having having to forego it altogether, which is concerning to hear. He goes on to say that we hope that by reducing the price of our Solait range, we can help make sun protection more affordable and allow families to stay safe in the sun. Those prices have already taken effect and they'll be frozen until the end of 2023. Next up is kind of a weird one. Biore apologizes for influencer TikTok ad that referenced a school. Now, I was actually sent this a fair few times, and a lot of influencers were kind of like sending it around because it's very bizarre. If you haven't heard of it already, here's the TikTok.
So countless obstacles at me this year, from a school to having no idea what life is going to look like after college. Supportive Mental Health Awareness Month, I'm partnering with Biore Skincare to strip away the stigma of anxiety.
We want you to get it all out. Not only what's in your pores, but most importantly, what's on your mind too.
Anxiety in my life has come in waves. I found myself recently struggling from seeing the effects of gun violence firsthand. I've had to intentionally set aside time for prioritizing my mental health.
I will never forget the feeling of terror that I had walking around campus for weeks in a place I considered home, with countless anxiety attacks to crying alone in my room at night. My message to you guys is that it's okay not to have it all together. Life continues changes and your thoughts will too. Do things that make you happy and know everything will work itself out.
Join me and Biore Skincare in speaking up about mental health by screenshotting this digital card and filling it out yourself. Every video posted is a step closer to normalizing conversations about mental health.
Biore pore strips and school things like, how are they linked? Well, apparently Biore want you to strip away the stigma of anxiety, and that's how. Influencer Cecile Max Brown is a survivor of the Michigan State University that happened in February of this year in 2023. In the video, Max Brown says that life has thrown countless obstacles at me this year, from a school to having no idea what life is going to look like after college. Which, as a statement in itself, is very much fair enough if you ask me. But I do think, and a lot of people thought, and why this garnered so much media attention, is that it's a weird thing to have within a sponsorship, not only for the influencer to kind of think up, but for also the brand to approve. I don't think anyone who hasn't been in her situation can really comment on how someone should deal with their kind of trauma, I guess, after that kind of situation, or what they should do with their mental health or their experience with mental health after going through something like that. It's life-changing and it's terrifying, obviously. But I think people's issue with this, and, you know, looking at tweets and comments on the video, which is now deleted, it felt very out of place with the video concept. According to the comments and tweets, people found this dystopian. They found it odd that something like so serious like that was being used to monetize. A lot of people said it was too soon. A lot of people found it very insensitive to other survivors. People found it odd that she was filming herself pretending to be sad. We don't know how she was feeling. But the whole thing looked very much set up like a day in the life of a vlogger type thing. One person tweeted, "That Biore team deserves all the fire it's about to catch for that ad, because why are you running paid social using a school shooting survivor referencing said shoot as a talking point in an ad for pore strips," which, when he put it like that, you know? Another tweeted, "These brand partnerships have gone too far. Biore teaming up with a mass victim to get it all out is crazy," another tweeted. Biore and the influencer took down the video after it went viral, after getting 5 million views. And Biore did release an apology, saying, "This is our mistake, we own it. We let our community down and our creators by not providing better guidance." And they actually said, "Direct all your hate, direct all your anger towards us and not the influencer involved." Next up, I'm going to go in with an eye cream. This is the Dew Skin Oracle Reviving Eye Gel. Just one of my favorites. Every day, light enough to wear even when the weather's so hot like it is today. Oh, that's too high. And I just say, this gives me a nice plumpness to under my eyes. It's very soothing, especially with my allergies at the moment, hay fever. My eyes have been itchy, they've been drying out. It's lovely and soothing and moisturizing and hydrating. So I'm kind of not surprised that Olaplex sales have plummeted. They reported that for the first quarter of 2023, compared to quarter one of 2022, Olaplex Holdings net sales fell 38.9% to 113.8 million. Oh no. President and CEO Jue Wong says she remains confident that the company can return to consistent and sustained sales growth. Olaplex reported that professional net sales were down 48.4 million, which is down 37.2%. Specialty retail was down 34.9 million. That's down 45.8%. Direct consumer was down 30.5 million, down 31.9%. Net sales decreased 60.3% in the US and increased 0.1% internationally. And Olaplex believe that this is down to three reasons. I have my own suspicions, but one, they say a lower baseline level of demand for core products in the first quarter of 2023, a negative year-over-year impact from inventory rebalancing. And I can't understand the first point, something to do with inventory and money and figures. Something about inventory pipeline. I don't know. In my opinion, they could be down in the retail sector because of that whole viral story that Olaplex made your hair fall out. Remember that? Remember? Is that still going on? I don't know. Yet when Wong was asked about this hair falling out drama and drying out your hair drama, she says it's kind of confusing because nothing like this has ever happened since they've been around since 2015. Like, it's never happened or been reported. And the formulation hasn't really changed. Dr. Chesana Kindred, who is a board certified dermatologist who specializes in hair loss, told BuzzFeed News that there isn't a form of hair loss that occurs from applying hair products topically once, unless you are allergic to that product. With Wong adding that Olaplex number 3, which is the one that a lot of people say you should be using because it's the most potent, was never designed as the conditioning treatment that everybody's treating it like. Wong goes on to say that they're assuming that Olaplex is a conditioning treatment that will make hair softer and more manageable, but is only really meant to change the structure of the hair without any sort of coating. And you see all these kind of like TikToks where people are like, drench your hair in this number 3, put it in a bun, put it in a hat and sleep with it. You're not supposed to do that. And I used to work in a salon and Olaplex was a huge part of kind of like our bleaching treatments. Depending on the hair type, we'd be like, you know, we're not going to do your hair unless you allow us to use Olaplex because it can snap, it can break. It was a system, it was part of a process. So when people started banging on number 3 on their hair when they didn't even have color in their hair or anything like that, I was a bit confused, treating it like a leave-in conditioner. I was like, I don't think that's really how it goes. Now, there is no current evidence that Olaplex leads to hair loss in any way. And whilst they did refund some customers, that wasn't them admitting that their products lead to hair loss. Lush has reported that they are recycling up to 80% of their own waste. Lush is a brand that I'm indifferent about. After mistakenly donating thousands of money to an anti-trans charity, I've been a little bit like about them, of course, obviously, but they have been putting money where their mouth is and donating to a lot of LGBTQ+ charities and launching several products to support trans rights. More recently, they announced that they are now processing more than 80% of its manufacturing waste via a new 2.3 million recycling plant, according to a report published by the BBC. The facility is known as the Green Hub, and it's capable of processing 500 tons of wastewater each year and 20 tons of plastic every week. They recycled 81% of Lush's own waste in 2022 in the UK. It's a little bit boring, honestly, but this made me think, in a world where people are like, you know, what's greenwashing? How do we be truly eco-friendly? It's cool to see stuff like this. It's refreshing to see a brand invest their own money back into making a real difference, especially taking responsibility for their own waste. I like brands that find solutions rather than sweeping things under the rug and being like, you know, here's a, I don't know, what? I don't know. What are you saying? Anyway, moving on. Wild deodorant, that deodorant that like, they're like native, they're just everywhere, everywhere. They are in trouble with the Advertising Standards Association for a misleading ad, and I like to see this. They've been asked to remove one of their adverts after basically suggesting that competing deodorants are toxic, that they cause cancer, worsened body odor, and were overall damaging for your health. Very misleading, very untrue. So the ad claimed that other deodorants were harmful and ineffective because they contained harmful ingredients like aluminum that were linked to health problems such as hormonal imbalances and rashes. We've seen it all before. Clean beauty bullshit. But this isn't the first time they've been in trouble for their adverts, no. Earlier this year, they launched an ad in which a pre-roll ad, which you see on like YouTube, you know, before the videos. This was for their Dirty Talk campaign, which was about a woman who was in a relationship with a polar bear and her kink was talking about environmental damage. And she's like, talk dirty to me. And that dirty talk is like, the ice caps are melting. I'll link it below so you can see for yourself. It's bizarre. They got in trouble with its ad because it's obviously inappropriate for a young audience, but it aired before a Dan TDM channel video. He's like a gaming channel, specifically like Minecraft, which of course kids are watching. So they were punished and told to take better responsibility when targeting their ads in the future. Here's a weird but interesting one. Researchers in the UK have developed a system to transform plastic waste and CO2 into synthesis gas containing hydrogen and glycolic acid. two chemicals used regularly in the beauty industry. They're saying that ultimately this technology could be used to reduce plastic waste and CO2 emissions while producing two valuable chemical products, including glycolic acid, which we use to exfoliate, an AHA, which I find really, really weird. I'm going to be using the Nice Birdie Dr. G SPF 50 Plus PA 4 Pluses. I believe this is a mainly mineral sunscreen, but I do think it has a little bit of a chemical filter in, but I do love this for my rosacea prone skin. They say the next step is to move from a laboratory experiment to full scale production by exploring ways to commercialize this process. This is what I mean by I'm not into brands who are just like, oh, you can reuse our packaging as vases, or, oh, we're donating so much money to this like eco-friendly charity, whatever, because it's not a solution. It's not a solution for an issue. I know when brands launch and people like, you know, we're trying to find ways to be eco-friendly, and people's reaction is usually like, well, the best way to be eco-friendly is to not exist at all. That isn't a solution. I would much, you know, we live in a society, we live in a world where people are going to use cosmetics. People are going to keep using and buying and creating. So brands and people that find solutions is what I'm more interested in at the moment. Like, we've got to be realistic, and pretty much saying just don't exist isn't a solution to anything, you know? Things like this interest me now, they really do. Anyway, again, thank you so much for Dermatica for sponsoring the beginning segment of today's video. Link below, discount code here, get yourself something nice. Oh, also, if you like slugging, the Restoring Ceramide Skin Balm is amazing as well, so check that out too. You can watch some more When Beauty Turns Ugly here, some beauty news here too, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there. We'll be right back.